You see, shame is sticky. It clung to my 4-year-old skin quite quickly. My legs were made for hopscotch, kicking, and jump rope. Instead of choosing fight or flight, I was flying empty in hope. And my arms were made for hugging trees and first slow dances. But I'm sitting here having forgotten my own prom and teenage romances. My hands should have been used for high fives and grabbing sweet victories, but they're callous now from holding a stockpile of missed out opportunities. I'm not as jaded and faded. Most of my scars are invisible. Flashbacks of a suicide attempt make the memory regrettable. You told me my pain was hard to believe because on the outside, I was always smiling. But faking it was easier than explaining my harmful methods of coping. And in the school of hard knocks, I got myself a doctorate. Life's so hard, I was the youngest looking college kid. And with an A score of 6, I'm looking at a lifetime of therapy. Many overlook my bravery because they're counting my profanity. Police say these are hidden crimes. But that's not true. It's not that we can't see it. It's probably because we don't want to. Hey, remember when we were kids and we just couldn't wait to grow up? Well, this was not what I expected. 3 years ago, I delivered a TEDx talk locally that became a launching pad to connect with survivors globally, even creating lifelong connections. I'm thankful to have met with survivors around the world. It takes two to break a secret. One to tell, one to listen. I'm surviving childhood sexual abuse. I don't have a secret anymore. I have a story. Now, I know I look young, but for me, high school was a long time ago. So you can imagine my surprise when I received a message from someone I went to school with. We had history. Notre Dame, East Van, class of 98. Schoolwork was a lot for him to juggle. Isolation and fear tried his best to make him buckle. He wanted to be brave, like how the lion saved Dorothy. But this world could be wicked like the witch, bankrupt morally. How could he speak up when society still makes rape against boys a parody? How could he speak up when society still makes rape against boys a parody? My public disclosure in 2014 gave him the green light, and his message to me, he wrote, "Because of you, I had the courage to say something. Because of you, I had the courage to say something. Because of you, I had the courage to say something." Hey, what's up? I was thinking about you. Since the last time we talked, I told a few people I was close to. These days, I'm feeling happy in my own skin, moving forward instead of questioning what could have been. Oh yeah, I've been taking more risks. I'm feeling confident. You see, his positive life changes were evident. Back when he first heard my story, he could see his reflection. Understanding connects humanity. We're hardwired for human connection. 2012, it was my first group therapy session. I was nervous. I spent the night before battling insomnia. Little did I know life was gonna change when I sat across from Geneva. We looked nothing alike, yet we shared a similar childhood, difficulty in relationships and navigating through motherhood. Back when I first heard her story, I could see my reflection. Understanding connects humanity. We're hardwired for human connection. Because of her, I had the courage to say something. Because of her, I had the courage to say something. Because of her, I had the courage to say something. But she said to me, "It's not easy. I'm trying to be a strong black woman, but I'm surrounded by Confederate flags and sexism, girls raised only to learn how to cook and make babies under religious extremism." Friends asked her, "Did you yell? Did you scream?" Then how'd he get in between? How can you speak up when society's doubting you? How can you speak up in today's America? Male entitlement to a vagina. Can you speak up if there's no one defending you? Verse 3, my heroine is bravery. Because of ongoing discussions about body autonomy, he knew he was the boss of his body. No apology. So he found it easy to come to me when the neighborhood kid touched him inappropriately. It takes two to break a secret. He talked while I listened. He knew he was the hero, not the villain. He knew that between him and I, no secrets, only surprises, and that I'll always believe him if he ever receives a touch uninvited. Who knew, 4 years after breaking my own silence begun, my work came back around to eventually help my own son. Because of me, he had the courage to say something. Because of me, he had the courage to say something. Because of me, he had the courage to say something. I'ma love you forever like you for always. As long as I'm living, my baby, you'll be. Who knew that breaking my silence meant saving the one closest to me? When will society take rape against boys seriously? When even the principal dismissed my son's assault as a parody. Jody, 12-year-old boys grab each other in the private parts all the time. That's what she said. I'm not kidding you. Her lack of understanding on consent proves we got a whole lot of work to do. Who taught you how to tie your shoelaces or cross the street safely? You see, the risk is in not knowing. If we cannot talk about sexual violence, we cannot help victims. If we cannot talk about sexual violence, we cannot prevent victims. And if we cannot talk about sexual violence, we will always be vulnerable. Because what's worse than your child being raped is your child never telling you. What's worse than your child being raped is your child left without a clue of who to tell, who to trust, who to blame. Was it just a figment of my imagination? Or perhaps they knew that they could, that they should, they just didn't know how. They might even think it's something they have to allow. But if consent and boundaries are a part of their vernacular, best believe they will grow up to become an ambassador that will speak for the voiceless, the ones suffering in silence, the ones without better life choices because they were accustomed to violence. It takes two to break a secret, two to break a secret, two to break a secret, one to tell, one to listen. And if you ever find yourself in this position, remember Alyssa, Christina, Gabriella, Leona, Kelly, Stephanie, Laura, Maya. Back when I first heard their stories, I could see my reflection. Understanding connects humanity. We're hardwired for human connection. So, dear child, we speak so that trauma does not have the last word. We speak for those not ready to be heard. Dear child, we believe there is no limit to your becoming. And because of us, we hope you have the courage to say something. Thank you.